Okay, so let's just jump straight in here to some SNMP configuration. What we'll do first is we'll enable SNMP using what you'd call the old method. So around about 12.03, Cisco changed the way that you enable SNMP server on an iOS router. So we'll do the old method first. So I've gone to R2621. This is our monitoring router here. It's running some SLA stuff for us, so we'll be able to use that later on, maybe in a different technical video. But today we're just going to enable SNMP server. So SNMP server is the keyword. Context help there? Question mark. You can see some choices there. We're just going to do some basic configuration today. So we'll go through the old way first. So SNMP server community. This is going to enable SNMP v1 and SNMP v2c in one line. So the way that Cisco look at this, you're basically enabling v2c's, but v2c backward compatibility with v1, so you'll be running both versions with this one line. So SNMP server community, then we give it a community name, so we'll just give it read-only community. And then after that you can specify whether it's read-only, read-write, which parts of the MIB tree you want to allow for. You can secure it with an access list, and we're going to go into that in a little while. So for now we'll just do SNMP server community, read-only community, that's the name, and we'll make it read-only, so it's a read-only string. Okay, so I'm over here on a Windows host. I'm going to be using one of the tools from the SolarWinds Engineers toolkit just to point at this Cisco router that we just configured with the read-only community string. It's going to be a very, very quick test just to prove out that it's working. I'm going to add a new gauge. That's the IP address of the router, and that's the string we just put in. You can test it, but it's going to work. We're not going to store it there. So what it does is it runs away and it does a quick SNMP probe of all the interfaces on the box. You can see them all listed there. We're just going to choose Fast Ethernet 0.0. Finish on that. It comes up with a nice, pretty graph showing the style of the gauge, so on. Let's change the update interval there. So you can see how busy it is. 3K a second. Not a very busy router, but it is getting the information from Fast Ethernet 0.0. There's the description of the port. That's the host name of the router. It's pretty good. Yeah, so the SolarWinds Engineers Toolkit, absolutely love it. When I'm off-site doing some consultancy work, I'll be using this toolkit all the time. It's got loads of great stuff in there. It's not just Cisco specific. You can do network discovery stuff like ping sweeps, port sweeps, and switch analyzing and things like that. It's all really good. So you can see you're getting updates there. Let's just put some load on the router anyway, just to prove that it's doing what it's supposed to. Let's do a ping of my local firewall here. Let's do 1,000 pings. Let's make them pretty big, 1500 byte packets there. Let's hop back over here, and hopefully there you go, 372k. So you can see this is pretty good. Okay, so we're back on the router now, and we're going to basically tear down the configuration we did before. So let's just get rid of all of that. No SNMP server community, read-only community, read-only, gone. The newer version of iOS since 12.03t uses a different syntax. Basically, Cisco thought when V3 came along, this is pretty unworkable. The SNMP server community and then type command basically enables, as it stands, V1, V2C in one line. So it's backward compatible, if you know what I mean. So the NMS could use V1 or V2C and access that Cisco router using SNMP, absolutely no problem. But when it's using version 3, that's completely different. So it's an encryption and authenticated protocol, and NMSs need a different way. We need a different way of making it more unique on the router's side. So we want an SNMP community for version 1, one for version 2, and one for version 3. Yeah, so Cisco changed the syntax of the command prompt here. So this is the new way of doing it. So SNMP server, we set up a group. We give it a group name. So we'll call it RO group. we give it a protocol version. So this is different now. So you can see we can split it up, and there you've got your new version 3 security model. And we can set the type, so it's read-only. And again, we give it a view name. Yeah. So we also now need to set up the SNMP server user. So this is a user of the group, and actually what we're stating here is the community value for V2C. So we give it a name. This is the name of the user, but remember, this is the community name. SNMP server user, and then a group, we add it to the group, which we just created, RO group, and then we give the protocol version again. What am I doing? What have I done wrong? Group to which it belongs. Ah, idiot. Okay, RO group, and then the protocol version. Yeah, of course. Right. So this is basically the same thing. So this was the original way we did it. SNMP server community RO community RO, with that's community name, and that's the read only read write sort of permissions. In this case, we've created a group, SNMP server group, RO group. We've made it V2C specific, and we've created a group, a view called read-only view. And then we've assigned a user to that group called RO user. So again, back on the Windows host here, we've got a problem polling now, because the original community group we had was RO community, and now it's RO user. So we just need to change this, and I don't think we can change it without... Oh no, maybe we can, maybe we can. Let's. I thought we might have to tear it down there. Let's just try changing. So our community is now RO user. We're okay on that. It's just doing a baseline, I think. It really isn't pushing 100 meg out of that. It's saying it's polling. It's got an issue with polling. What's the problem here? Let's have a look. Oh, it's because we've not set the rights to the view. So we just need to give it some permissions in that view. So we do an SNMP server view, SNMP server view, view name. So this was RO view. And now we need to add the MIB view values. So we've got things like MIB2. Oops. Is included, beg your pardon. Let's add that in. Cisco included. I think that's probably all we need to get that to start polling. There we go. So now it's polling because we've added those MIB views. So if you remember, what we spoke about here was it was basically tearing down the tree, making certain parts of the tree visible to the SNMP agents. Yeah. So we just added MIB2, which is what started the bandwidth counter there clicking over, and anything Cisco specific on the router. So anything that's not included is excluded. So anything we don't, it's just like an access list, anything we don't include here is lost. So now we've got that polling away, and that's all good. Let's just have to double check, yeah. So there we go. Yeah, great. So, what do we need to do now? All right, so we've got remote read-only, old way, read-only, new way, everything read-write, exactly the same thing, but instead of where you see is putting in read, yeah, you put in write, and where you see is putting read-only, for RW, same thing, and obviously you have to do the view thing with the new syntax. But this is we're still screwed with the security problem, right? So if someone gets hold of our SNMP community string, then we've lost access to that router, because they can just go in there and do what they want. If it's read write, obviously if it's read only, all they do is get the telemetry that we're getting. But we want to make it secure, right? We want to make it secure. So let's show how we do that. So the old way, we would configure an access. Let's put the old way back in. So let's get rid of this. Let's just do a no on that. What else have I got? No on that. Where have we been? Where have we been? That one. No on that. And no on that. That should all be gone. That should be timing out now. Let's just wait for the repoll. Come on. There we go. Time out. So there's no SNMP enabled now. Let's put the old one back in. So SNMP server. Remember, this is the old way community. And we give it a community name. So RO community. Community. And RO only. Yeah. view. So here now you see we've got access lists. So this is what we're going to do. We're going to basically secure who can and who can't see us with an access list. Actually, let me just check what IP address I've got over here. I think this is using a bridge, so I'm kind of going hosed, I think it's using. Is it using that? Let's have a quick look here. Excuse me. My IP address is 34. Oh, good. I am bridged. Excellent. Okay. So 34. So we're gonna create an access list that allows me to come in. So access list 1 permit host 192.168.1. Actually, let's not allow me in. Let's allow somebody else in. Yeah. So we've set up the community value and we've permitted host 1.33 to be able to see the router. Okay. Now I know that this Windows host is 34. So I'm still getting a timeout. In fact, let's just change this community value as well, because that won't work, will it? Community. There we go. So this is still going to fail, hopefully, because my IP address is 34. Yeah. Whereas that guy's expecting me to be coming in on 33. So this should still fail. Let's get rid of that. And it is. Okay. So no poll. Now let's add in 34. So remember, we're blocking it. We're giving read-only access to anyone permitted in access list 1, and we've only permitted these two, 33 and 34. 33, I wasn't allowed in. 34, that is me, and now the timeout's gone away, and I'm polling again. So all good stuff. So that's the old way, securing that with access list. We'll keep the access list because that's easy enough to put in the new access list. So we'll just put that in. Let's get rid of the old configuration. SNMP server, community, read-only, community, read-only. And let's put in the new syntax. So remember, we've got the SNMP server group. Let's give it a read-only group. V2C, read view name. So this was a read-only view. And then we've got access list again. So access list 1. Now, what we're going to do here is we're going to put our user into that group. Anyone that's in this group, anyone that's assigned to this group, will be assigned to this access list and this view. Okay, but as you'll see, you can state access lists per user as well. So SNMP server user, RO user, and then the group, RO group, V2C. We can add another access list and make it more specific per user, but we don't need to do that. So we've got RO user added to the group, V2C, and did we set up a view? We did set up a view, so we need to do the view as well. So SNMP server view, and it was called RO view, and we need to add the MIBs in, MIB view family name, so this was MIB2 included, and Cisco, I think we added as well, included, and now, hopefully, this should poll at the next attempt, if it's right. Oh, the community name, beg your pardon. So the community name is still set to community. So our user was RO user, right? And this is the new community name. So RO user, and then straight away, straight in there. One final thing we need to cover off in the basic SNMP configuration is SNMP descriptors. There are three things in Cisco IOS. There's contact information, you've got location, where geographically the box is. You know, you're probing it, but you don't know where it is really. And then finally a chassis ID. So let's just go ahead and do this real quick. SNMP server being the keyword. Chassis ID, let's do that one first. So this is the asset tag. This could be the serial number of the box. It's absolutely fine to use either. SNMP server location. Where is this box geographically in the world? So we'll say it's in server room A, building 3, London, data center. And we've also got contact information. So this is the network team the B team, who are also located in building 3, and their extension number is 1234. So those three pieces of information might be really useful for an engineer who's just come cold on site, and those are the sorts of things that you can pull back from your NMS software. And if that changes, obviously if you move your router, you change the contact information or the location information, but the chassis ID probably would say the same. So that's about it for today. Thank you very much for listening, and I hope to see you next time.